Two is better than one, or at least the CDC says so.
Yeah, I've got the paper one on the inside and then the cloth one over it.
What you need to know about double masking.
And it may not be Christmas, but baby, it's cold outside. We'll give you your weekend weather update coming up.
Wintry weather rolls through Northwest Arkansas. I'll tell you how students are coping with the cold. UATV starts right now.
Frozen February continues, and it's not leaving anytime soon. Good evening, and welcome to this Thursday night edition of UATV. I'm Lexi French.
And I'm Sydney Brooks. That's absolutely right, Lexi. The icy roads led to another round of closures across Northwest Arkansas. Some schools, businesses, and city activities delayed today. The University of Arkansas delayed its classes and transit until 11 this morning. And that weather won't go away anytime soon. Current forecasts put this weekend's temperatures dipping through the teens. And this Sunday, Valentine's Day, you may just want to stay in, grab a blanket, and snuggle up because it may dip as low as 0 degrees. Current predictions say we may not see the sun or temperatures above freezing until late next week.
As such, the University of Arkansas community is gearing up for a chilly weekend and record-setting lows next week. UATV reporter Heidi Kirk is out on campus to tell us how students can prepare for the cold front. Heidi, what's it looking like out there?
Lexi, I hope you brought your mittens because it is absolutely freezing out here and it's not getting any better. Now we'll continue to see temperatures similar to these next week and they're only dropping. Now the university actually delayed classes today until 11 a.m. and it's quite possible that next week we will see more of the same. I spoke to university officials that told me that the best way to stay up to date on university updates are through your phone. Now just check your text messages and your emails. Now commuting to campus can be quite hard on days like today when sidewalks and roads are iced over. So it's important to make sure to check road conditions before you leave. I spoke to one student, Zach Stanley, who told me that he bikes to campus 4 or 5 days a week, and this weather definitely put a wrench in things. Now his one piece of advice to students that bike is to look out for those icy patches.
If you see those coming up, better just to get off and walk through those and then try again, or just don't bike at all.
Like Zach said, it might be better to just not bike to campus on days like today when those sidewalks are completely iced over. I'm actually standing in front of some stairs that are quite icy, and sometimes it might not look that they are, but actually they're completely covered in ice. So whenever you're embarking on your journey to campus next week, make sure to look at the sidewalks and check the road conditions. Live on campus, Heidi Kirk, UATV News.
Thanks, Heidi. For additional information about the university's inclement weather plan, you can visit safety.uark.edu.
Early this morning, several NWA schools announced that they are closing their doors today and tomorrow. Closures include Fayetteville, Springdale, and Rogers Public Schools. Additionally, Fayetteville's trash and recycling services were suspended through the end of the day. The Full Circle Food Pantry on campus also closed its doors for the second day.
Governor Asa Hutchinson made efforts to help people affected by icy roads this week. Governor Hutchinson tweeted yesterday saying he would activate the National Guard to help during the icy weather. Today, he encouraged drivers to check iDriveArkansas.com to see the conditions of their routes.
The Arkansas Department of Health reports nearly 16,000 Arkansans received a vaccination against COVID-19 since yesterday. ADH reported that just over 440,000 doses have been given in total. Arkansans in Group 1B are currently eligible to receive the vaccine.
Arkansas COVID-19 numbers continue to drop following their January peak. Total active cases decreased by nearly 700, making the total over 13,000 cases. Total cases increased across the state by over 1,000, with the total death count rising to over 5,000. and the Center for Disease Control released new guidance to help improve your mask's effectiveness. The center recommends snugly fitted masks and picking a mask with layers to ensure disease prevention. They also recommend using a mask with a nose wire and checking for gaps around the covering.
The CDC also recommends wearing multiple masks at once, commonly known as double masking. CDC officials say that Americans should wear a disposable mask under a cloth one. The second layer helps decrease the spread of COVID-19, according to the CDC. One U of A student says that he will continue to follow the advice of national health professionals.
Well, I've always believed in following the recommendations of people actually focused on figuring out how to beat this, so I'm big on that.
While the CDC says any mask works, double masks significantly decrease the risk of spreading COVID-19. And we asked our UATV Instagram followers what they think of double masking. More than 80% answered they do not double mask. Be sure to follow us on social media at UATV News for the latest on our coronavirus coverage.
A recent mandate from President Biden and the CDC requires mask wearing on public transportation, like planes and buses. At XNA, the mandate requires any children 2 or older to wear a mask when previously those under 10 did not have to. PR specialist with XNA, Alex English, says that masking in the airport has not been an issue since the start of the pandemic.
We really haven't had any issues with passengers being non-compliant, not wanting to wear their masks. We have a pretty wonderful community up here, and so that hasn't been an issue. If anybody ever is asked to put a mask on, they're pretty quick to do so.
The mandate comes as part of a larger push from President Biden to get more Americans wearing masks in order to help slow the spread of the pandemic.
Senators met for the third day of the trial of President Donald Trump. Democratic impeachment managers concluded their case today, asserting that Trump incited an insurrection. Tomorrow, the former president's lawyers have up to 2 days to present their case defending Trump. Conviction requires a two-thirds majority of 67 senators.
And the Department of Labor released its latest unemployment numbers, showing a drop in jobless claims. 793,000 Americans filed for unemployment last week. These numbers have held just about steady for the last 3 weeks, but still remain higher than pre-pandemic levels.
The Springdale Housing Authority now accepts applications for rent and utility bill assistance as part of the Washington County COVID-19 Assistance Program. Applicants can pick up forms at the City of Fayetteville's Community Resources Office. Pickup and drop-off hours take place Monday to Friday from 8 to 4:30.
The City of Fayetteville broke ground today for the new public safety campus. The event took place at the project site just off of West Dean Street and North Porter Road. The building will serve as both a new fire station and a new police headquarters, building for the Fayetteville Police to keep up with the growing city.
A Bella Vista man will go through a third trial for his alleged murder of his 6-year-old son 6 years ago. The Arkansas Supreme Court overturned the state's appeal in the case of 51-year-old Mauricio Torres. A jury found Torres guilty in 2016, which the Supreme Court overruled 3 years later. Last year, another jury found him guilty, but the court was declared a mistrial when a witness jumped off the stand to attack Torres. Now a third trial will take place and a new jury will try Torres for murder.
The UAPD spent the day yesterday showing the Lady Razorback self-defense techniques. Athletes from the volleyball, cross-country, and diving teams worked with 2 officers from the university police. In addition to learning self-defense, participants had the opportunity to meet K-9 Officer Charlie.
A survivor of the Holocaust speaks to the U of A, how he hopes to change Arkansas, coming up.
And find out what international award Fayetteville won this past week, coming up after the break.
I'll never forget the day our landlord called and said, read your lease. No pets allowed. My owner tells him my dog ate the lease, but that didn't work. And now I'm stuck in a shelter, but this pit bull is ready for a new crib. I'm loving, loyal, and play well with others. So don't be intimidated by all my muscles, because the biggest one I have is my heart. That's right, I said it.
Thank you. Want to call those hogs at your favorite sporting event? No can do.
So if you lose me, you could be paying that $18 replacement fee yourself.
Protect your life on campus from mayhem with your student ID card.
A lot of people call us handlers and caretakers, and that's okay. And then some people say we're owners, but we are not owners. All Razorback fans everywhere, all over the world, own a little piece of him. We just see after his day-to-day activities and well-being and take care of him. Tuts4 has retired. He is now in retirement mode, in retirement home. So he just plays in the mud and still gets some grapes, but just not as much belly rubbing as he used to get. We've picked out Tuts5, and you pick him out for how he interacts with people, how he interacts with fans and things like that. You want him to have a good deposition type. He's going to be very active, a little spastic, a little running around. Got a great personality. Of course, his mud hole is the number one thing he likes to do. And I've had some people say, you know, how does it feel to pull in a stadium with 75,000 people screaming? And I said, the first thing you got to remember is they're not screaming at you. They're screaming what's in that trailer. The thing that I really enjoy is when the fans come up and the little kids come up and their eyes just get big as silver dollars because they just can't wait to see Tusk. But I've had people come back to me and say, I still remember my first Razorback game, but the only thing I remember is Tusk. I don't remember if we won or lost, but I can remember meeting him. It just gives me a way. I feel like I can give back to a state that's given me so much.
Cyclists International, the world governing body of cycling, names Fayetteville the first bike city in the United States. To give us a personal look at how this award affects locals, Rebecca Pipes is live. Rebecca?
Thanks, Lexi. Being named a bike city is a huge honor. Fayetteville is now in a group with Berlin, Copenhagen, Montreal, but today I wanted to speak with a Fayetteville local.
Probably when I was 12 years old, my dad bought me a bike, a mountain bike, when I was 12 for Christmas, and then I think 6 months later, in June, we went on our first ride at Slaughter Pen. It was definitely a memorable ride. It was kind of chaotic, had no idea what I was doing, crashed a lot, but also had some of the most fun I've ever had in my life.
Northwest Arkansas is where Landon Kennedy grew up biking. Now, Fayetteville is named the first bike city in the U.S. by the UCI.
It is an interesting pick. I mean, I've traveled quite a bit specifically for mountain biking, so to like state that this is the place to go biking is interesting.
Mayor Lionel Jordan says this is a powerful affirmation of the work Fayetteville has done for decades and continues doing. In 2021, Fayetteville plans to host 3 different professional bike races: mountain, cyclocross, and road bike racing.
There's definitely like an invitation for those that are new into the sport to feel welcomed and feel invited.
Fayetteville is a city for biking for everybody, but I don't think a lot of people are out biking in today's conditions. So be safe out there. And reporting live in Kimple Hall, Rebecca Pipes, UATV News.
Thanks, Rebecca. Fayetteville plans to continue using biking as a means of transportation and leisure in the future.
The University of Arkansas hosted an interview with Holocaust survivor Peter Konstam this afternoon. Born in 1938, Konstam lived downstairs from the family of Anne Frank. The lecture, introduced by Chancellor Joseph Steinmetz, had more than 350 attendees. Konstam shared a story of his swallowing a piece of paper which listed the names of allies who risked their lives to protect Jewish Germans.
And if they would have seen those names, they would have definitely send them to a concentration camp as spies. And so we saw that daily.
The Q&A comes as some Arkansas legislators work to pass a new bill mandating Holocaust education in Arkansas. After a year of reconciliation, Black History Month returns to the U of A. James Morgan will tell you how you can celebrate Black history around Fayetteville.
And the School of Journalism and Strategic Media celebrates an anniversary with a big award, the new recognition for SJSM.
Sometimes we can do things that exclude others.
You're still talking to your friend?
It's complicated.
I think he went back in. We gotta go get him.
Welcome to Jumanji!
Even the smallest words and actions can have a big effect on someone. You have the skills. Because of you, someone's entire day, their year, or their life can change.
Remember, the future is in your hands.
Visit becauseofyou.org to learn more.
Totally, let's do it.
Hi. I'm your student ID card that you just lost under the couch. Sure, you could replace me, but if you don't, just think of all the things you can't do without me. Without me, you could be paying for that meal out of pocket. So if you lose me, you could be paying that $18 replacement fee yourself.
Protect your life on campus from mayhem with your student ID card.
I want to eat apples and bananas. I need to eat apples and bananas. Why can't I eat apples and bananas?
Support the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks to help provide meals to those in need. Join us at feedingamerica.org.
When I first saw a turtle, my heart was full. Now I'm anything but lonely.
We have this like deep connection, this heart connection.
He just wants to be close to you and part of your life.
Every day with Turtle is a perfect day.
When I'm holding her, it makes me feel calmer.
I think everything he does shows how much he loves us.
When we adopt a shelter pet, we discover they're a little bit of a lot of things.
But they're all pure love.
Score going to the playoffs.
I can't believe I missed that.
Every time I'm buzzed, I spend too much time on my phone.
What? I should take your phone away.
No. I'll call for a ride. Hey, why does my face look like that?
I'm playing with these new face filters.
Okay, you know what?
Yep, that's mine.
I'm going to need that back.
Nope.
Kevin!
The University of Arkansas continues to host Black History Month events. Though a few events are held in person, most of these events have gone virtual this year. UATV's James Morgan has more. James?
Thanks, Lexi. I'm at the Multicultural Center in the Arkansas Union, where normally they would be holding multiple different Black History Month events during this month of February. But due to the pandemic, they've had to move a lot of these events online. Despite this change in format, these events are still happening at the same rate, with an event happening almost every day in February. These events include virtual panel discussions, film reviews, and even film showings. There's also a virtual soul food cooking class that'll happen, along with several Northwest Arkansas business owners. This is all part of a celebration of Black heritage and culture.
Black History Month is a time where Black people can kind of celebrate the heritage, the culture, and just, it's all kind of curated. It's Black, I feel I'm so jaded maybe when it comes to Black History Month, because I feel like every month should be Black History Month and we should always celebrate our heritage and our culture.
One of these events, called Sweet Chariot, told the story of an enslaved person's journey to freedom. It provided a historical perspective to Black history, even though it was not part of the Multicultural Center's programming. There are many events like this that aren't part of the Multicultural Center, but are provided by other various departments and programs across the university. The Black History Month events will culminate with a Black Heritage Showcase on the last day of February. Reporting for UATV, I'm James Morgan.
Thanks, James. A full list of these events can be found on the Diversity and Inclusion website at diversity.uark.edu.
PR News named the U of A School of Journalism and Strategic Media on its 2021 Education A-List. The list recognizes the best institutions advancing the careers of PR and communication professionals. With the list, SJSM ranks among the elite, fully accredited journalism schools in the country. SJSM celebrates its 19th anniversary this year.
Coming up in sports, Arkansas baseball hits home runs on SEC records.
And details about tonight's women's basketball game against Mississippi State after the break.
Traffic paradise. Okay, we can only get rid of some of these big honking trucks. And these yahoos on scooters.
Oh my goodness. Come on, you jerk! You're committing suicide! And then I'll get blamed because you're an idiot. Your parents raised an idiot. I bet I'll see your idiot butt in the classroom one day. And you'll prove I'm right. You're an idiot.
I would say the VAC is a group of students who are dedicated to service in specific areas, and so they find their passion within the different programs, and they want to get other students involved and help Northwest Arkansas. I was super involved in high school, and so I figured that that needed to continue into college, but it was hard to figure out exactly where I wanted to dedicate my time and where I was passionate about, and so kind of meeting different people throughout freshman year and then being involved with freshman service leaders for the VAC gave me an introduction into what they do, and that made me want to continue to be on the board as college progressed.
You are the change! Woo!
Gonna pay that parking ticket with Razor Bucks? Not without that student ID card.
So if you lose me, you could be paying that $18 replacement fee yourself.
Protect your life on campus from mayhem with your student ID card.
Today I'm going to talk to you about physics. Come on in, girls. Let's go. This is the first rocket to get humans to Mars.
Really tall.
I'm a rocket structural engineer, designing and building parts of the rocket. You are the generation that will be stepping foot on Mars. Do I have a group of astronauts on my hands?
Yes.
You can become a rocket scientist or whatever else you want to be.
Welcome back to UATV. I'm Jack Kettles with your Thursday sports news. Four Razorback baseball players swing and hit league-high records for the third consecutive year. Catcher Casey Opitz, second base Robert Moore, outfield Christian Franklin, and designated hitter Matt Goodhart were named on the 2021 coaches preseason All-SEC University team. All four players recorded impressive stats. Primary catcher and team captain Casey Opitz recorded excellent batting averages of .203, .361, and .509, including six doubles, a home run, and 11 RBIs. Opitz is ranked the number six catcher in the Division I baseball's preseason position power rankings heading into the 2021 season. Debuting as a freshman hog last year, Robert Moore recorded batting averages of .317, .403, and .400, with two homers and 17 RBIs. His RBI total and batting average ranked third for first-year players. Moore also earned SEC Player of the Week and Perfect Game National Player Week honors last season, making him the first freshman in the program's history to do so. An already named a preseason first-team All-American, Christian Franklin enters the 2021 season as one of the top prospects in the nation, recording batting averages of .381, .467, and a whopping .619, along with three home runs and a team-best 21 runs scored in those 16 games. Matt Goodhart picked up the preseason All-SEC honor for the second time, slashing .302, .400, and .492 throughout those 16 games, along with three home runs and 18 RBIs over 63 at-bats. The 2021 season begins next weekend with the State Farm College Baseball Showdown at Globe Life Field. Arkansas will take on Texas Tech Red Raiders for the first opening, and the first pitch is set for 7 on Friday, February 19th. And the number 18 Arkansas women's basketball team faces Mississippi State tonight at Bud Walton Arena. The unranked Mississippi State Bulldogs are coming off a 23-point loss to the number 1 South Carolina Gamecocks. The Bulldogs stand at 3-4 in conference play, while the Razorbacks hold a 4-6 record. Arkansas ranks number 1 in the NCAA in free throws made and free throws attempted. The game starts at 8 and will be broadcast on the SEC Network. That's all for UATV Sports. We'll be back with more after the break.
Now, just 4 years isn't enough time for being at the corner of leaving home, and I have no idea what to do. Thankfully, Pat Walker Health Center is always here to help, like creating new ways to help you ditch bad habits. We offer ways to keep you healthy, like the walk-in clinic for minor illnesses. And when you need peace of mind, the 24/7 counseling hotline for you is there. We'll do more than help you get well. We'll help you stay well and live well. That's what it really means to be at the corner of Garland and Maple.
Initially, I started looking into volunteer opportunities as a way to practice my English. So I found Give Pulse online and I started signing up for different opportunities. Let's Walk Food Recovery is an organization that recovers food from the dining halls, the food that is left over, that is untouched by the students. We pack it, we measure it, we send it to different partners around the community.
You are the change! Woo!
Sure, I look cute now, but when my owner lost his job, it was rough. I was living on the street, and one night, me and this Cocker Spaniel got into it so bad, I wound up looking like an ice cream cone. I cried a little bit, but thankfully I got rescued, so I'm running, I'm jumping, all back to my old self, and I'm ready to give unconditional love, even if you put a lampshade on my head.
Learning community, you know there's about 20 people who have the same interests as you, so it kind of helps you transition and feel a little more welcome.
We all stayed in the same wing of the hall, so I always had, you know, those few people at least I know I could turn to if I didn't have like anybody else.
So would you say I'd love a chance to be?
Being able to be in the same classes like with all of the people on your floor is really helpful, because then you all have this.
That's all for UATV News. I'm Sydney Brooks.
And I'm Lexi French. Have a great night.